There's going to be an item in tomorrow's Vanity Fair written by Monica Lewinsky. After more than a decade of virtual silence, Lewinsky is speaking out about her affair with President Bill Clinton, saying it's time to, quote, burn the beret and bury the blue dress. She also writes that she's had deep regret for what happened, and what did happen was a relationship between two consenting adults. Why now?
I mean, I don't know why now. She says partly it was because of the fact that there never was a perfect time. She delayed telling her story to not affect Hillary Clinton's run for the presidency in 2008.
Which could be happening again in 2016.
Or to affect President Obama's reelection campaign. So when's the right time to tell it? She also says she's telling it because she was really impacted by the suicide of Ryan Clemente, the Rutgers student whose roommates taped him kissing another man. And so she said, I had my own suicidal thoughts at the time. I'll buy that. I mean, I think those are all potential reasons. You also have all the political prognosticators or the people trying to spin it saying, well, she's going to do damage to Hillary's campaign and she wants to do that, or that Hillary and Bill, you know, coordinated this timing so that the story would be done with before she... I don't care about that part of it. I think that's pretty rank speculation at this point.
I think part of it also may be that, you know, she's trying to craft her own narrative in terms of the history of what happened. I think that's going to be difficult for her because that history is already been written. It's still being written by others, mainly by, you know, presidential historians at this point. So she may shed some light and add some context to what's being written now, but it's going to be difficult for her to craft that narrative in a way that's
going to... To want to tell her own story. It's out of her control at this point.
Well, and I have to say, the one thing that I'm sorry to hear her say is that this was sex between two consenting adults. Now, she can say what she wants. She can feel what she wants. But, I mean, let's look back at it one more time and take the politics out of it. But here was one of the most powerful people in the world, almost 50 years old, having sex with a 21-year-old college intern. By definition, that's an uneven power relationship, if nothing at all. And what I'm glad is that even though I don't agree with what she's saying, the fact that she's raising this issue at all in the context of all the talk we're having now about sexual harassment in the military or on college campuses, if this will shine a little more light on that relationship between the women who were engaged in sex with generals or football stars. I mean, it's a good thing that we're talking about.
Quickly, before we move on, one of the things that she said is that thanks to Matt Drudge, she was the first person to have their life and reputation destroyed on the internet. Looking at this today, it's not 1998 anymore. Again, talking about the changing media landscape. How might this be different if covered today?
I don't know if it's going to be different. Mm-hmm. I think you're going to see more of it because the media has just exploded, especially when you start talking about digital and online and blogs and that sort of thing. So I think it would have, if you have a similar situation to that today, it would even be blown up even more exponentially.
It'd certainly be snarkier. I mean, you've got to post a BuzzFeed sort of parody of all of it.
And now you've got the comments. I mean, you didn't have the comments.
Commenting then. Yeah.
But I do have to say that I think that if the Drudge Report, back at the time, there were very few media outlets, and Newsweek had this story. Had they done the story, then Matt Drudge might have been a different character today than he is now.